Hi, Super Mario is back with a short review. I was up in the attic to find a very special flashlight that I have that I want to show you, that is brilliant to have if you are camping or something like that. And I'm going to show you this right now. I can't fit the whole entire unit in the camera at once, but I'm going to guide you through this anyway. I'm going to talk about the flashlight from ED-Line. Model number is L30. And it's a very huge and advanced flashlight. I'm gonna start with the front here. You have the flashlight. There's nothing more to say about that. At the top, you have a strap that you can take out and hook it up here so you can carry it over your shoulder, or you can take the strap and place it here. This is a very advanced flashlight because at the top here, see if I can do this. Yes, I can. You have a selector switch here. Tube, off, light, and blinking. Probably used to find people in the fog or something, I don't know. As you can see on the unit, it has a power indicator here. It has an FM and AM switcher here, which means there are radio on this one. AM, FM. You can switch on the radio at the top here. Later down, volume, on and off. It doesn't have any batteries inside now. Earphone. It has a plastic lid on this, but I don't know where that is. It's gone missing for a long time ago. And at the side here, or at the bottom first, speaker. At the bottom, model number and so on, L30. And you have a tube at the side, light tube. And this unit here, if I turn it around here, it also have a siren button at the top here. You can push in and you get a siren sound on this. This is the antenna at the top. And here is the battery lid. I haven't put it all back yet because it's a little bit hard to get on and off. I will find batteries to this later. It goes on 6R20, the biggest batteries. So this is a very nifty light to have. It had a lot of functions, radios and tube, but be aware of one thing, when you use the tube on this one, it drains batteries, so you better have a bag of batteries to this one. And the normal flashlight, it's okay, it's a flashlight. So, and it's a very nifty one, you can also hold it in the handle here at the top. So, and this is just to wind in the wire here. So, this is a nifty system. I had it up in the attic for many years, and I think to myself that, yeah, when I'm up at the attic next time, I'm gonna make a review of this one, because this is very good. High sensitive receiver, 2-band, FM, AM, speaker here, and the speaker is fairly good. And down here is information that if you are using the tube, the AM will shut off because of noise. Only FM can be used with the tube on, but that's because of the noise you get from the tube that blocks the signal from FM. No, sorry, AM station. But I can guarantee you this works perfectly fine. It has FM band from 88 to 108. Go a little bit above, as you can see as well. So this is a good system. So there you have it. I just want to make a short review of this one because I think that's a funny light to have. I also got some other lights that also using the tube, but it's not as advanced as this one. I have one other, I don't know if I can make it out. It's too far away from me now. 2 seconds and I will find it. Hold on. I can take that one. Can I make it to this one? Yes, I can. I have two more to show you here. So, I have two more here. This is the simple model. It's just a tube, and you can put batteries in at the bottom. And this is from a company called Sonka. You have off and on here. But what's good about this system? It's on the other side here. You can also use it on the net. It has an input for a battery eliminator here. 12 volt. The battery eliminator takes, and it takes 6 of the biggest batteries, which means it's 9 volt inside on batteries. that leads me to believe that you can also use this on with a 9-volt adapter if you don't have a 12-volt. I don't think it will make any major difference. And I have tested this, works perfectly fine with an adapter. I use the adapter to my keyboard actually, to this one. Yeah, I have some instruments that I play sometime. And I also got one more of the same kind, but this is a little bit different on the top. This has a blinking, if you have a car, if your car breaks down and you don't have a warning sign, you can use this and it will blink in the night. And if I turn it this way, you have a 4.5 volt normal bulb, light bulb in here, and you have a 6-volt here that blinks. And I think it's nifty. This one doesn't have any adapter input for to plug it into the electricity. It only takes batteries. You have fluor off, spot and flash. Fluor, that means this fluor bulb here. So that's another flashlight that I have. And I think it's actually good to have this one, because sometimes if there's the power in your house is gone because you get out of power because something is wrong, you can use this as a replacement in the bathroom, for example, and get good light anyway in the bathroom. And you can take the shower that despite that the electricity is gone. So this is nifty. That's the tree light with fluor bulb that I have, or what it called, this long hair. In English I'm a little bit, I'm not sure. So I call it a fluor light. So there you have it. That's some flashlights that I wanna show you. Do I have more? Yes, I have. And I got this one from Sonka. And this has a, you have a handle here, or you can take the handle out like this, and it can stand on its own, like that. And this one takes 4 of the batteries, and I think I have batteries in this one, because this is in daily use, yeah. And you have also possible to have a spare bulb at the top here. So this is a good system, and I like it a lot. Let's see if I can get that lid on. It's not easy on camera to do that, but let me see if I can do that. And I have one more to show you. And yes, it works. So it's okay. So this can stand on its own, or you can carry it by turning it around like this. And it's a good flashlight. One more to show you about flashlights. Hold on, let's see if I can get this one. There we have it. And yes, I have this one. This one, you can use a big battery with 2 feathers on the top. I haven't seen the batteries in the store, but this has an adapter, so I put 4 of the R20 batteries inside. And you have a flashlight at the front, also a little bit yellow on the side. This one works perfectly well and lights up perfectly well. So that's it. That's the flashlights that I can show you today. So I think it's a little bit funny, because you need it sometimes. Sometimes you might go down to a basement where the light is gone or something, and it's very nifty to have a flashlight laying around. That was the review that I have of flashlights. Thank you for watching, and have a pleasant evening. Bye.